a queen. And then the actress said, but he, pointing to her bodyguard, sees the queen every day or every week. The tourists were so excited. Oh, you mean you'll meet with the queen? Come, let's take a photo with you. And then they give the queen the camera to take a photo of themselves and her bodyguard. Now that's really interesting, isn't it? They were in the presence of the queen. You know, they could have taken a photo with the queen, but they never knew who the queen was. But there was something interesting the bodyguard said, that she's very funny. She can be hilarious sometimes. Well, that was just what the news piece online said. But my point here really is that you can be in the presence of the queen, of the king, and you can miss it. But I'm here to tell you about a king that never dies. A king that once died but resurrected. A king that you've heard about. We celebrate during Christmas, even if most people leave him out of the party, but he's still the king. He's the king that is coming again. He's the king that created the queen, the king that created you and created me. Permit me, guys, this lovely afternoon to quickly read the Bible from the book of Isaiah. I'll be taking a text from Isaiah chapter 9. Okay. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For a child is born to us, unto us a son is given. The government will rest on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His government and its peace will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of Heaven's armies will make this happen. Now, if I were to ask you what eternity means, I'm really certain that most of us, or maybe all of us, will say it means forever and ever. Eternity has got no end, does it? Does it have any end? Eternity is timeless. Eternity is endless. Eternity is beyond us. But what's more intriguing is that we make a decision that would, you know, that would determine where we will be in this kind of eternity, right here on earth. And most people are not even getting ready. Most people don't care enough to really dig in, to really search, where will I be in eternity? You see, friends, if you remember the story I just told us, how those US tourists gave the camera to the queen herself to take photo of them and her bodyguard because they never knew she was the queen. In similar vein, most people, you're walking around, living your life the way you want to, not acknowledging the king who is right here, the king that you can meet, and the king that you will still meet, but hopefully you would have known him here, because that's the only way to be in his presence in eternity. There is a king that never dies, a king that once died, a king that will never die again, and a king that is coming again. Friends, the name of that king is Jesus. You see, Jesus came to die for you and I. Jesus came to save us all. But oftentimes, we're too caught up in our own ideologies, philosophies, mindsets, to even seek the truth. But we need to seek the truth, because only the truth will set us free. Going back to my story, just imagine if the tourists had known that the queen herself was right there with them. I'm sure they would have preferred to take a photo with the queen rather than taking a photo with her bodyguard. The point, friends, is that all human institutions, all of us, you and I, will one day die. I hope we'll live a good life here. I hope we'll have a good time. I hope we'll grow old. Either way, nobody will leave this world alive. We're all going to die. That's without any question. I think the question is, when we die, where are we going? If there is a life after here, if eternity is real, where will you be? Most of you, before you go on your holiday, you check for your flight, you look at hotels, you check if the area is good, lovely places to visit, all of those lovely things. But it's really, I don't know the word to use. You know, it's really intriguing how we don't even prepare for a life after here, a life that's longer than this, eternity. Now the question perhaps is, how can one prepare? The easiest way to prepare is to simply give your life to Christ. What does it mean, give your life to Christ? What does that even mean? Well, you see friends, we've all sinned and fallen short of God's glory. So when we say give your life to Christ or be born again, all we're saying is we repent of our sins. Repentance means turning around, turning away, being sorry for, changing, as it were. We repent of our sin by confessing it to God in prayer, saying to God, "This, I know this is wrong, I'm sorry, forgive me." And then believing in the Son of God whom he has sent to save us. Jesus is the only one who died for humanity. Jesus has paid the price, and vicariously we can gain or be seen as righteous by God and forgiven for everything we've ever done because of the blood shed by Christ, because of the holy life that he lived. Once we believe in him as Savior, we need to also honor him as Lord. What that means is, imagine if you were in the military, for example, you know, you have a commander, you know, you're given instructions and you follow those instructions, which is the, you know, the usual. In similar vein, when Jesus is Lord, he has his own instructions, which we follow. Okay? Now, Jesus' laws or commands are for our own well-being. For example, love your neighbor as you love yourself. Right? Imagine this kind of command. If all of us were walking in love, living in love, if I don't have any cause to harm you, I have nothing to, you know, against you, if I have your best interest at heart, imagine if all of us had that kind of mindset, just imagine how beautiful this world would really be. Well, friends, in the midst of all the chaos, a lot of people blame God. Oh, if God was alive, why did this happen and whatnot? We forget that we humans are the cause of our own problems. We're the ones doing what we do to each other. But that's why Jesus came, to forgive us for the past, to help us to live the right kind of life now. But you see why most people reject Jesus. Jesus has been marked as the most hated man in the world. If you talk about Jesus in the workplace, you may be looked at funny. But other kinds of religious activities outside of true Christianity is somewhat accepted in most places today. Why do people reject Jesus? Because they don't want authority over them, because they want to carry on with their sinful life. Now, we've all fallen, we all have a sinful nature, but that's why Christ came, to forgive us, to help us, to cleanse us. So this message is a message of love, not of condemnation at all. It's a message of hope, that regardless of what you've done, how far you've gone, Christ can save you. He just wants to save you. He wants to heal you of the past. He's not guaranteeing that everything will go perfectly the way you want it, because Christ actually came for us to follow him. Jesus is not to follow us, we follow him. So if we're doing anything wrong, we stop what we're doing and align our lives and the way we live to his word. Praise God. In summary, friends, there is a king that is coming. This king was once here. This king died. He died, but he rose again. We've lost a queen. We've gained a king. We've lost a queen that we love so much. But there is a king who created the queen. Many may be curious, where's the queen now? That's a question only God can answer. But I can reassure you that anyone who dies in Christ, anyone who believes that Jesus is the Savior, who accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, will be in heaven, because God is faithful. He said, whosoever believes, whosoever, you, no matter your creed, your community, LGBT, Whether you're Asian, you're Muslim, you're black, you're white, Jesus wants you. Jesus loves you. Jesus died for you. He wants to save everybody. Everyone is welcome to serve the King. Everyone is welcome to surrender to Him and to have eternal life. This is a message and a call. There's fire on the mountain. Nobody's leaving this world alive. We're all going to die. There is a life after here. There's eternity. Where will you be? To prepare for eternity, you need Jesus. Jesus saves, and His love has been shown to us by His death. And for you to receive that love, you need to repent, believe in Him, and make Him Lord of your life. Thank you very much. God bless you. Father God, whatsoever things we do not know, please teach us. Who we are not, please make us. And what we don't have, please give us. In Jesus' name we pray. If you need Bibles and, you know, got questions, we're here to help. God bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Huddersfield, men and women of Huddersfield, we've come today to tell you about Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is your Savior. Jesus Christ is the one who will save you from sin, from hell, from judgment and destruction. You need Jesus Christ in your life. You need to turn away from sin. You need to turn away from worshiping idols. Turn away from worshiping mammon. Turn to Jesus Christ. He's the only one that can help you. He can heal you of all sickness. Only Jesus Christ can take away disease and sickness. He's the only one who can save the world. He's the Savior of the world. The Bible says in John 3:3, Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. If you want to see the kingdom of God, you must be born again. That's what Jesus Christ says. He says you must be born again. It simply means you must turn away from sin, turn away from a life of disobeying God, turn away from a life of stealing or lying or cheating or sleeping around or disobeying God or rebelling against God. Turn away from all that and choose Jesus Christ. He says you must be born again. In verse 7 of John chapter 3, he repeats the same thing. He says, Marvel not that I said unto you, you must be born again. So don't be surprised that the gospel is coming to you today. Don't be surprised that God is commanding you to turn away from sin and to turn away from unrighteousness. Come out of darkness and come to the light of Jesus Christ. It's the only way by which you can be saved. So this message is for all men and all women. Women, Muslims, Sikhs, LGBT, Jehovah's Witnesses, Catholics, every man, every woman. Jesus is calling you today to repent, to be born again, turn away from your ways and choose to follow Him and follow Him alone. Just the way He says in the book of Luke 9:23, He says, If any man will follow me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily and follow me. You need to deny yourself of your pleasures, of sin. Deny yourself of the pleasures of sin. Deny yourself of the pleasures of this life, because it's all vanity. The Bible says vanity upon vanity, it's all vanity. Deny yourself of vanity, trying to make money, and you forsake the love of God. You love money more than God. You love yourself more than God. That's vanity. Because in the end, it will all pass away. it will pass away. But one thing will not pass away is the word of God. This same word will never pass away. So that's why you need to think about your life. If you die right now, where will you go? Heaven or hell? So this life is not the end. When you die, you're going to stand before your Creator. You're going to stand before God. You stand before the Maker of heaven and earth, and you give account of your life. You're going to tell God how you spent your life, every second, every minute, every hour, every day, every week, every month, and every year of your life. You're going to tell God how you lived your life, if you obeyed Him or if you disobeyed Him. And you're going to give account. So Judgment Day is a day that you should be prepared for. You need to think about Judgment Day, because Judgment Day will definitely come. Are you ready? Are you ready for Judgment Day? Are you ready? Some people say they are ready. Are you ready for Judgment Day? One day you stand before God, and if you've bowed down to idols, you're going to give account. If you've broken God's laws, you've chosen to sin against Him, you've chosen to disobey God and rebel against Him, you're going to give account. So when you stand before God, what will you say? There's only one advocate who's going to help you on your Judgment Day. Only one advocate, and that's Jesus Christ. You need Him now. You need to invite Him to be your advocate. You need to invite Him to stand before you on Judgment Day, because if you do not do that now, on Judgment Day, it will be too late. You need an advocate, and that advocate is Jesus Christ. You need to invite Him into your heart, invite Him into your life, ask Him to come into your life, because only Him can forgive you of all your sins. Only Him can make you brand new. Only Jesus Christ can change you and transform your mind and your life. You need Him more than you need air. You need Jesus Christ in your life. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived by the lies of the media, or the lies from the schools, or the lies from the government, or the lies from religion, that there are many ways to heaven or many ways to God. That's a lie. There's only one way. Jesus Christ says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. You cannot get to God without Jesus Christ. He's the only way. Every other religion is false. Every other way is false. Every other way will lead you to hell. That's why Jesus Christ left His throne. He came to die for you. He loves you so much. He loves the world so much. He loves everyone in every kind of religion. He loves you so much that He gave His life. He shed His blood just to save you, just to save every man and every woman and every boy and every girl. That tells you how much He loves you. Jesus loves you so much, but do you love Him back? Will you love Him back by obeying Him? Will you love Him back by accepting Him into your life? Do you love Jesus Christ more than your crack? Do you love Jesus Christ more than your addictions? Do you love Jesus Christ more than alcohol? Do you love Jesus Christ more than your girlfriend or your boyfriend? Do you love Jesus Christ more than money? Do you love Jesus Christ more than your religion? Jesus is calling on you today. Come out of religion. And He says, follow me. Follow only Jesus Christ. Because He is the only way. He has lived His life and He has given us a perfect example. He's given us the perfect example that we should follow. Jesus Christ is the perfect example for all mankind. You cannot fault Him. Jesus is sinless. Jesus is blameless. Jesus is our perfect example. And that's why we should all strive to be like Him. We should all strive to follow Him. Strive to follow Jesus Christ. Only Him. Follow Him and Him alone. Because He wants to lead you to life. Many young people claim, they say they love Satan. They want to follow Satan. Satan will lead you to hell, because he has been condemned to hell already. But Jesus Christ will lead you to heaven. He will lead you to life. He will lead you in the right path. Choose Jesus Christ today. Choose Him today, and you'll never regret it. There are testimonies all around the world of people coming to Jesus Christ. They're coming to Him. They're turning away from sin, turning away from rebellion, turning away from unbelief. Many people are turning away from unbelief. Turn away from not believing in God. Believe in the only God who can save you. Believe in Jesus Christ. Come to Him today. Come to Jesus Christ today and you will never regret it. Come to Him today. He is the only way. Think about it. There is no other person who loves you more. He loves you so much that even while you are in sin, while you are in your pleasures of sin, He died for you. And He will forgive you over and over again. But not until judgment day. A day is coming when the grace of God will cease. And that's why you need to get right with God. Because time is running out. Please come to the Lord Jesus Christ today. Stop being deceived. Stop being deceived. Stop being deceived. Stop being deceived. There will be judgment. You're going to give account for your unbelief. You're going to give account for not listening to the word of God. You'll be judged. The Bible says, as many who do not receive the gospel of Jesus Christ, they've condemned themselves already. So if you reject this gospel, you've condemned yourself already. But Jesus loves you. He doesn't want you to end up in condemnation. He wants you to be saved. Young man, Jesus is calling you today. He's knocking on the door of your heart and He's telling you, give up your cigarette smoking, give up your vaping, give up your sleeping around. God is not pleased when you do all this stuff. He wants you to repent. He's calling to you today to repent. Turn away from your lifestyle of sin. Turn away from drunkenness. Turn away. Turn away from sin. Many people love football more than they love God. Turn away from such pleasures. Don't be deceived by the pleasures of entertainment or the television or your gaming. You know, some people, they love their gaming so much. They spend hours and hours and hours just gaming and gaming, and you're wasting time. You need to come to your Savior. Come to your senses. Come to Jesus Christ. Do not forsake this precious love. Jesus loves you so much. How will you respond to His love? How do you want to respond to the love of Jesus Christ? Will you reject His love, or will you accept Him as your Lord and Savior? The Bible says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish but have everlasting life. For God so loved this world. For God so loves you. For God so loved you that He gave His only Son, begotten Son, that's Jesus Christ, that if you will believe in Him, if you, James, will believe in Jesus Christ, if you, Matthew, will believe in Jesus Christ, if you will turn away from this world, turn your back on the world and turn to the Lord, turn to Jesus Christ. He's knocking on the door of your heart and He's calling on you today to repent. If you can feel your heartbeat, or if you can hear your heartbeat, that's God knocking on the door of your heart. He's knocking on the door of your heart and He's calling to you today to open your heart. Open your heart that Jesus Christ will come in. Ask Him for mercy. Ask Him for forgiveness. And He will definitely forgive. He'll come into your heart. He'll wash you and make you brand new. Jesus loves you. Turn to Him today. We've got free Bibles, free copy of the Bible. If you want a copy of the Bible, we'll gladly give you one. Give you a copy of the Bible. We've got booklets of John for you. Find out the truth. Find out how you can be saved. Find out how much God loves you. And find out why you need to turn away from sin. Because there's heaven and there's hell. And the choices you make today will determine where you will go. So we pray that you accept this word, that the gospel will come into your heart and change you and make you brand new. The gospel of Jesus Christ is for the saving of all of mankind, every man and every woman and every boy and every girl. Come to Jesus Christ today. Don't be deceived. Stop living a life of deception. Choose God. Choose Jesus Christ. Amen.
But the distance there is, the devil is taking us so far away from God. Yes, because we thought or believed that we can handle things on our own. But believe me, Jesus is the only solution to your problems. Jesus is the only power, the force that can change you from the inside out. The voice of Christ is the only voice that is directing you to where you meet your life and live your life. That is the only voice that is ready to save. The voice that says, come to me, ye that labor and are of heavy laden. Jesus said, if you come unto me, I will in no wise cast out. He is able, very much ready to help you out, to direct your ways, for you to live out your life here on earth, and for you to please his Father. Turning our back to God is very dangerous. Doing things on our own is very, very bad, because at the end of the day, you are going to stand before God. And how are you going to handle that? Maybe you believe that there is no God anywhere, and suddenly person dies, and behold, you are standing before him. What are you going to do? Come to Jesus. He is the Savior of the world. Come to Jesus and receive your salvation. Come to Jesus. The Bible said to him, those that believe in him, they shall never die. Come to him. He is the only one who promised and kept his word. Come walk with me. The road is straight and narrow. Come walk with me. You cannot walk alone. For the road is rough and there are many dangers. Come walk with me and I will see you through. Continue to say, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart. He wants us to learn of him. He wants us to take our steps like he did. He wants us to live our lives like he did. Blameless in everything. He lived a holy life. There are situations, I tell you, that supposed not to affect your life if you're living with Christ. Yes. He's the only perfect human being. And by going with him, I tell you, your life is going to produce wonderful fruits. Yes, fruit of the Spirit. There are things you might be struggling with your life to stop doing, but I tell you, you can't stop them by your own strength. You can only do that by the power of Christ. Yes, so many times you got into your house and there are things you did and you're not happy with it. But the next time you think, how am I going to do this? You cannot handle it alone. Come to me, all you that labor and are of heavy laden. I will give you rest. Jesus is calling you today. Jesus is calling you every day. Jesus is calling you even now. Come. Do not allow this very season to pass you by. Come. Do not allow this time to pass by. Come. He is willing to help you, to assist you living the right life, to help you overcome all the challenges you're facing, to help you to overcome all of these things you will do without knowing how to come out from them. Come to me. Jesus loves you more than any other thing, more than every man. He loves you to the point that he gave his life and died for you. He loves you so very much. Yes, all the love that Christ has for his people. Come unto me. The day is now. Yes, now is the hour. Now is the time. Come to me, you that labor and of heavy laden. So many troubles out there, circumstances and situations, turning things and people around. There are so many things that are drawing away, us away from God. There are so many activities out there that we think or believe that there are ways over there, but the truth of the matter is there is no way in all of this. The only one that got the answer to our work in this world is Jesus, because he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one cometh to the Father except by me. If you walk with me, you will never walk in darkness. That's his word. That is the word of Christ. If you walk with me, you will not walk in darkness. Without walking in Christ or with Christ, surely you walk in darkness. And the activities of the darkness will compound you every corner. So much more that you wouldn't even remember who you are. Come walk with him. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And don't be deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man sow, that he's going to reap. And that is why Christ is trying to do everything to bring you to himself, to avoid reaping. Oh my, the reward of our disobedience. Do not allow the voice of the world to blindfold. Don't allow the voice of the world to keep you away from God. The voice of entertainment, don't allow it to disturb you. Voice of riches and materialism, do not let them stop you. Voice of friends, people, you know, out there, disorganizing your mind. Sometimes you decide, I am not going to do this again. The next moment you are in there. Wow. One voice we're expected, are supposed to hear, listen to. That is the voice of Christ. He is calling. Jesus is calling. Will you answer him today? Jesus is calling. Will you make yourself available? Christ is calling. Will you open your heart unto him to come in? Jesus is calling. And he can do whatsoever you think. The Bible said he's going to do exceedingly, abundantly, above what we think or ask, according to the power that worketh in us. Oh, my brothers and sisters, don't let this time pass by. Do not let this moment pass you by. Listen to your heart. A voice is saying something. Come. Come. It is season. Come. Come walk with me. The road is straight and narrow. Come walk with me. Well, you cannot walk alone, for the road is rough and there are many dangers. Come walk with me and I will see you through. Come walk with me, the road is straight and narrow. Come walk with me, but you cannot walk alone. Now the road is rough and there are many dangers. Come walk with me and I will see you through. Wherever you are this moment, that you want to give your life to Christ, just say after this, or after me. Even though you don't want anybody to hear, it doesn't matter. You can say it in your heart and say, Lord Jesus, I have come today. Be my Lord and personal Savior. Save me from sin. And give me the spirit to live for you henceforth. And I pray for you that the light of the gospel shall shine upon your life. From today, you shall be a witness to this world. God bless you all. In Jesus' name, amen.